radio contact with the outside.
Hey, 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 what's up everybody? Spellcheck here with my Shinobi build. I'm here on a butter knife, whatever you want to call it, dagger. Let's get right into it. So as you can see, just like the rest of my videos, my stats are, not so great. But anyway, I still get the job done. I'm rocking Sayatara on her right now with the Nemesis weapons. The Nemesis weapons come in really handy for the stones you can put in them. Godslaying jewelry. Basic stuff. But anyway, it's effective. So let's pop right in here. Here's my page one talent points. So you can see where I'm spending points. I'll go into why I get what I get here in a second. Here you can see the page two talent points. Pause if you need to, as always. Just to see where I'm sticking it. It's pretty self-explanatory, but... Alright, so these are your hardest hitting physical moves. These are the ones worth investing a lot of points in because they're nasty at max rank. So, I'm just going to go over these real quick, let you see them. The other ones I've put all the points into, they just don't get as high multipliers as these ones or add-on damage. So the percentage plus the add-on damage is going to be the highest you can get physically anyway. Well, that frog is actually pretty good too, but I don't really use it because I don't like long animations. This is great for when you have your dodge up, your counter move or whatever, because you get a free 20% crit. This is nice because you're going to be dodging and using your evade a lot, so you might as well be dropping a dummy that leaves damage. And this is just going to boost all your techniques, which are all your elemental damages right up here. So your fire, your earth, your water, your wind, and your lightning. So, yeah, pretty much a bigger boost than pushing them up one by one individually. The lightning can get pretty nasty if you put a lot of points into it, though, the thunder escape, but I don't really do that. This, I don't push past level one because 35 seconds goes along with the wind escape, which is 35 seconds, so I'm not really going to push more into that. So, as you can see here, my basic all-around combo, I use this on bosses and PvE. I really don't have to change much. I might switch out, I don't know. I might put the toad in there instead of lightning or something, but I like it the way it is. I'll just demonstrate the combo fairly easy, line it up. You can actually keep things juggled for a while if you want to, and it's going to fill your meter up really, really quick. So that was just the first two bars leading into each other, 21 hit combo, no biggie. I'll build up my meter real quick. So my range, I'll just pop my mana, pop my fireball, and then as that's going through them, I'll go ahead and dash through them to get some big mobs. That'll fill your meter up because you're gonna hit a lot of different enemies. So you can turn right around and hit them with the jutsu, whatever it is. And then this, I'll drop those two, and then I'll step back and put the wind vortex in them. So that's when I'm luring mobs. I'll lure them to me, drop the two wind techniques, and then put the earth technique in there to pull them into those wind techniques to make sure they're eating that damage. It's really effective, as you'll see in a dungeon run that I do. Build my meter up again. So with this, you'll drop those two as they're running towards you, and then you'll just drop the earth technique to pull it into them. See, I kind of stuffed this one up. I usually step back a little further. You want that wind tunnel or the earth technique to pull them right into the middle of your orb so all of them are hitting them repeatedly, as opposed to just the outer edges ones. Okay, so for the free crit, anytime you have your body substitution up, your dodge technique, you're getting a free 20% crit, which will boost. Like, I don't have a lot of crit, but people with higher crit than me are going to start getting a lot of crits with this up. So you can already see little yellows speckled in there with mine, and it can get really, really, really nasty. Because the way crits seem to work is they come in strings. So if you get a nice little crit started, it can sometimes chain multiple times in a row, and you'll just see yellow numbers all over the damn place. But I only had a base of like 2%, so it gives me 22%. But see if I can't get a string of them real quick. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Oh, yeah, there we go. See, yeah. So it really just comes in strings. And like I said, the more you invest in crit, the more that's going to benefit. But I think that's enough explaining. Like I said, the build's pretty self-explanatory, and you'll see how I use it in the upcoming run. But thanks for watching, and let's just get into this video, shall we? All right.